A fish-heavy diet can help curb human depression, but what if I told you those fish might have been raised in a depression-prone sadness farm? Yes, a new study published in Royal Society Open Science argues that growth-stunted, anorexic dropout fish that float listlessly at the surface of their overcrowded tanks are suffering from severe depression. After all, we're not talking about a ritzy aquarium or a stock pond here. These dropouts swim about in cramped, unnatural, stressful aquaculture environments that have more in common with cattle feedlots, overstuffed prisons, or those human battery towers in the Matrix. Now I know what you're thinking. Even fish pain remains something of a contentious issue, so how do we get to the idea of depressed fish? Well, according to lead study author Marco Vindas, the doomed dropout fish express behavior and brain chemistry in line with depression in other organisms, namely high levels of the stress response hormone cortisol. They found that dropout salmon's serotonergic systems, which regulate cortisol, were overactive, overstimulated, and defunct. The fish were so stressed that they didn't respond to further stress. Human fish ethics aside, growth-stunted dropout fish are a common and costly occurrence in salmon aquaculture, so farmers have more to gain than a sadness-free fish sticker in tackling the problem. And they don't necessarily have to improve tank conditions if they can improve the fish themselves through research into stress-coping genetic markers and selective breeding. Hey, then you don't have to change a thing. Though the paper also indicates that several common aquacultural practices may play a role, including the employment of stressful vaccinations soon after smoltification, the naturally stressful physiological adaptation of juvenile salmon from freshwater to seawater. Vindas, a marine biologist at the University of Gothenburg, also believes these findings could eventually aid in the medical prevention of human stress-based pathologies, as well as the depression you might be feeling right now about the source of your fish sticks. So how does that sit with you? Let us know, and if you crave more weird science wonders, be sure to check out now.howstuffworks.com each and every day.